Hey, what's up, you turkeys? Today we're camping and we're making hot dogs. I hope you like chili cheese dogs and sauteed red peppers with onions. It's gonna be good.
The hot dog is a time-honored tradition for any camping retreat. Roasting a hot dog over an open flame is probably one of the most rewarding things you can do for yourself. Even better still, your hot dog bun acts as an edible plate, so you don't have to do dishes because you've just eaten them.
I don't want your dishes, it makes me sick.
It'll make you sick, it's just water.
Okay, first let's start with the fire. You see two schools of thought taking shape here. You've got the teepee, you've got the log cabin. Both work fine. The clear favorite has to be the log cabin.
Hey guys, make sure you like and subscribe. Hit that bell if you want to keep up with our videos.
You want to get the prep work done first, just like cooking. So when it's showtime, you're not frantically running around trying to find the right piece of wood like a jackass.
Don't take from my pile.
So the hardest part about starting a fire are the early stages. Help yourself out by providing enough oxygen to the flame. Help yourself out even further by not putting your face 2 inches from the fire and blowing as hard as you can.
Oh, I'm getting smoked, bro.
Looked out. Yeah.
Instead, construct a fan. Simple, yet effective.
All right. Hot dogs come in all sorts of shapes and sizes, along with quality and flavors. You can skewer your dog with a stick if you don't have a grill. If you're going with a skewer, have a couple of backups. This technique is known to steal a few dogs if you don't skewer them properly. We're out here in the Pacific Northwest, and you know what? This is a great place to find your fruits and vegetables in the forest if you can. I don't know if you guys know this, but actually the red pepper tree, it grows out here, and they can get pretty big and pretty red. Let's check it out. Let's see if we can spot any red peppers around here. Oh my God, guys, check this out. Come here. This is a beautiful piece of red pepper. Smells really good. So we've been camping for a couple of days now. All we're gonna do for our toppings is use everything that's left over. So we made a burrito and we made a stir fry. So for the burrito, the leftovers we have is cheese and Cuban beans. We're gonna mix those up together and make a chili cheese dog. And then we're gonna take the leftovers from the stir fry, which is onion and red pepper, garlic, mix that up, saute it, put it on the hot dog with a garlic mustard aioli. It's gonna be really good. And we also have some leftover chips. Those are great to put on the side of hot dogs. I like to crunch them up, sprinkle them on top. Gives you a nice little crunch with your dog.
Think about the technique, the physical technique.
Joey Chestnut is the greatest ever.
He is the only man to ever consume 70 hot dogs and buns here at Nathan's.
This is actually the first time I've had a chili cheese dog.
Me too.
I've never had one. It's weird, but it's perfect at the same time.
That is absolutely amazing.
Mm-hmm. You didn't go for the chip.
Hot dogs package the meal together so perfectly.
Mm-hmm.
What is it about like an open flame, and why does it feel so good making food over an open flame?
It's like nostalgic for like our ancestors, I guess. Maybe it's just part of our DNA.
Camping is the only time we can actually barbecue. It's such a hassle, mm-hmm. but it's worth it.
Like, we don't have a barbecue at home. We mm-hmm. live in an apartment with no balcony, so.
We need this.
It's not that bad. Okay, now for this specific room, it's not that bad, but it's actually not that bad, you know?
At least for me, like, this is actually not bad. Like, it's pretty.
Man, grilling a dog over the flame, listening to it like sizzle up, all the oil's like bubbling out of it and stuff.
I would way rather have a hot dog over the fire, over a boiled hot dog,
I'll do them if they're really high quality. Well, there's so many boiled hot dogs that are gross. Like, think about going to 7-Eleven. If you're getting a hot dog off a roller, you're in trouble. You can make gourmet hot dogs, that's a thing.
Yeah.
For sure. You can chef them up a bit.
It's all about the dog you get.
It'd be the most difficult meal to make while camping. Homemade ravioli. Yo, imagine you went camping with a bunch of people and like pranked them by making homemade ravioli.
A master chef cooking show where everyone's camping. Yeah, you're given like the regular person's camping gear.
Yeah, you have like a Swiss Army knife.
It's just like a Swiss Army knife and a plate. That's it.
This is how we record sound in the forest when you have no boom.
Oh, I'm getting smoked, bro.
Smoked out.
Fuck.
Well, see you later.